My name is Alex and welcome to a brand new quick tip by JANUS Engineering. A colleague recently showed me this trick in Siemens NX and I knew that it had to be included in our NX tutorials. A very common problem when deburring a workpiece is that it's sometimes necessary to deburr the edges that do not belong to the actual part itself. Today I'm going to show you a good way to deburr those edges that don't belong to your part but that belong to the in-process workpiece. The great thing about this quick tip is you don't have to laboriously derive the residual material geometry from the actual workpiece.
And that brings us to our example. Our example for today is this part that's displayed. The part is constrained to the clamps, and if you notice on the left in the operation navigator, there is already operations created. The machining for this part's already almost finished. Let's take a look at the toolpath verification for all of our operations. We'll click Verify Toolpath, and then once that pops up, we'll go to the 3D Dynamic tab. We'll set our speed and start our verification. As we watch our toolpath move, we see that the part is being manufactured and the stock is slowly being removed. The interesting thing about the specific toolpaths on the part right now is that the toolpaths are leaving the center of the pocket filled for an easier manufacturing process and to save time cutting. But the challenge now for this is how do we go about deburring all of these surfaces? Not only the core, but also these edges down at the bottom. To begin, let's go into our IPW and say create. Then when we do so, we can see that the IPW is now saved within our CAM part. To find this body that was just created, we can go to our part navigator. And then if we look under the non-timestamp geometry, there is now a new facet body available for us to turn on and off to be visible. This is the IPW that we just created. Well, what do we do now? We're now getting to the actual tip of this video. We're going to go into the geometry tab of the operation navigator and then right-click on the MCS main and insert, and then geometry. When the dialog box opens, we'll then select a new workpiece and click OK. We can then go into the workpiece and specify the part. We want to pick the IPW that we just created. When we scroll over it, you can see that NX is not going to allow for us to select this. That's because of the NX out of the box settings. This is automatically going to be set to solid body. If we go up into our upper tab, we can change the solid body selection to no selection filter. Then we are able to select the body of our IPW. We then check OK and OK again. When we created this new workpiece, we can see that the MCS was created underneath it automatically. We don't need this, so we're just going to delete that MCS out. Next, we can select our workpiece and add it to the inside of our first workpiece. Not just inside of the workpiece itself, but we're going to actually put it right under this zero top MCS. Now this workpiece has the information that the part geometry and the IPW that was left over from the verification before. We then right-click on our new workpiece and insert a new operation. We're going to select mill contour operation as our type, and then the operation subtype is going to be three-axis deburring. We're going to make sure that our program order is set to program, this is correct, and then the tool is this ball mill that we have built inside of here. When we click OK, our operation dialog box pops up. If we go ahead and generate this operation without changing anything, what happens? Now, the operation is looking at all the part geometry and is trying to figure out where the edges are that it wants to deburr. So now that we have a toolpath, when we click the toolpath on the edge down here, we can see that it is being deburred, just like the core geometry up here on the top. We can also see that the operation is doing a lot more moves and cuts that we actually want it to. For example, these holes up on top. The operation sees that there are new edges here, so it wants to try to deburr the inside of those as well. So how do we get rid of those? For this, we go into geometry. We're going to specify our check. And then once that dialog pops up, we're going to select our workpiece that we began on originally. When we say OK, and then we generate again, we can see that the toolpath is only deburring the leftover stock without touching the part itself. We see that the deburring is happening down here on the corner at the bottom, but also up on the top around the core geometry. So what else can we do? We can also go in and change our deburring depth. For example, instead of the 0.5 millimeters, what it's set to right now, we can add more depth to it, so we'll do 0.8 millimeters. And when we regenerate that, we can see that the path drops down farther into the part. If you would like to know what possibilities you have to deburr planar geometries, you have to check out one of our past quick tips. Simply click right up here.
And just like that, we deburred or even chamfered material that doesn't belong to our actual workpiece. And while we are on that topic of an in-process workpiece or raw material, it's worth checking out this video that shows you how to, you can find your ideal raw dimensions with the help of NX and save a bunch of material at the same time. Don't forget to leave a comment, like, or subscribe to our page to make sure you don't miss out on the next quick tip. I'll see you in the next video.